Chapter 37 Durangamam et charam Asariram guhasayam Ye chittam kanyamissanti Mukhanti mara bandhana Durangamam et charam Asariram guhasayam Ye chittam kanyamissanti Mukhanti mara bandhana. I think you have heard this name of the Buddha on many occasions. I always refer to this name because here the Buddha explained the nature of human mind. It is very difficult to understand the nature of human mind, very subtle, confused, very deep, developed, and can twist the mind very easily, change the mind immediately. So, most unreliable thing in this world is human mind. Very difficult to trust. Our own mind, not others' mind. Yes, I cannot trust my own mind because I may change my mind due to certain influences or temptation or emotion. Or anger, irritation. I know Dhamma. I can understand what is right and wrong. Even then I have no courage. Or I have not developed the mind up to that extent not to change the mind. Now this situation remains until we attain the first the stage of Setu, Sotava, uncertainty of mind. This is the nature. Durangama. Dura means far. Gamang means goes. Goes very far. Durangama. Eka chara. Live alone. Two minds cannot exist together. Never. That is why always there are some differences, discrimination, conflict, argument, disagreement, because two minds are not equal. Husband and wife also the same. Entirely different mentality. But don't try to make one mind. Then no fun. It's very dull. Negative, positive must be there. Important thing is understand. My wife is like this. My husband is like this. This understanding is important. Don't try to change. Then you know how to adjust yourself. To cooperate, coordinate, compromise. Otherwise, cannot work. Asariram. Sarira means body. Asariran means no body, means no formation. Mind has no formation. It is invisible. No one can see the mind. But we can see the nature of the mind through certain indications, expressions, features, face, the whole body, every action or every word express or indicate the nature of a person. Guha saya. Guha means cave. Sayang means not your sayang, but that sayang is related to this word, sayang. Guha sayang. Living. Sayang means living. Living in a cave. Guha sayang. Ye cittang sanjamesanti. Ye. Adava yo. Singular yo. Plural ye. Ye cittang sanjamesanti. Those who subdue, control, train their mind. Mokkhanti. Mokkha. Moksha is a very common word in every religion, especially every Indian religion. Moksha. Meaning of the word is free. Mokha Pali, Moksha Sanskrit. Free. So Buddhism introduced also Nirvana as Mokkha or Moksha, free from suffering, in that sense. Hindus, in every Indian religion, they use the word Moksha. Moksha to them is heaven or paradise. Moksha. Here Mokkhanti means will be free. Free from what? Free from mara bandhan. Bandhan means, what is the meaning given here? Bond. Bond of mara. Time also, we say bandhan. Time. We tie. Bondage also called bandhan. Bond also say bandhan. And trap also called bandhan. Will be free from the trap or the bandhana or the bond of mara. Here mara is not a person. I have told you this word mara we use for certain things, not only a person. Devaputto kilesocha abhisankhara marako khandamaro machumaro mara panchapakasita. Five kinds of mara. Mara lecture also here. Not that type of mara. Devaputta Mara. Devaputta Mara lives on the highest Devaloka. Jatum Maharajika, Tavatingsa, Yama, Tusita, Nimmanrati, Paranimitta Vasavati. That is the top. So the Devaputtas or Devas who live in this particular Devaloka are called Mara. they are very powerful, very forceful, very energetic, but not very religious. Usually devas are not religious, but these Maharas, when you compare with others, they are not very cultured. They like cruelty, wicked, bad thing. They encourage people to commit bad things. That is why other religions always say, when people hold some different views or belief or idea, they say influenced by devil. Here devil means Mara to us. Buddhism always say influenced by Mara. Same idea, same belief. Deva Putta Mara, they do exist. This is means. Next one is Kilesa Mara. Kilesa means mental impurity. Mental impurities mean the ideas or the thoughts pollute the purity of the mind. Mental impurity. Now, anger is mara. Jealousy is a mara. Hatred is a mara. Cruelty is a mara. Wickedness is mara. Mental impurity. Another meaning of mara. Abhisankhara. During our lifetime, we accumulate lot of karma. Another word for this karma is sankhara. The sankhara divided into two, wholesome and unwholesome, good and bad. So all the bad karma that we have accrued by committing evil, these karmas are called mara. Because these things completely ruin our future life, our fate, to suffer. Because of these bad karmas, we had to lead a miserable or unfortunate life. Therefore, bad karmas are regarded as mara. Khanda, mara. Five khandas. Rupa, Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara, Vinyana. Five. These five khanda, khanda means deep. These five khandas also regarded as mara. Because of these five, we had to suffer. We do not suffer if these five deep or component things join together, these five groups. Rupa, Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara, Vinyana. Meaning, Rupa matters, elements, into one. Then the mental side, Vedana, Sanya, Sankhara, Vinyana, feeling, perception, and mental habit and consciousness. Five. These five combined together, life comes into existence. Otherwise, there is no life. When the life appeared, from the beginning up to the end, enormous suffering. Because of this combination. If these things were not combined together, there is nobody to suffer. Then we aggravate the situation by clinging, developing our attachment towards this five. Trouble start from there. Our attachment towards this five aggregates. When changes take place in these groups, then we worry, we cry, we fight, because we cannot tolerate the changes. But they are changeable. That understanding is not there. We suffer because of this company. So one day, the Buddha told Ananda, if anybody asks, why human beings suffer, you can give only very simple answer. They suffer because of their birth. If there is no birth, there is nobody to suffer. All the other causes for suffering is wrong. The main reason for our suffering is birth. There is a well-known Hindi poet in India. He has composed very nice poem in Hindi language. Now I cannot remember. I can remember the meaning. It's very meaningful. He says, we were taught that God created us. In spite of that, we also ask to worship Him. I really cannot understand why we should worship Him. Because of His creation, we are suffering. If He did not create us, there is nobody to suffer. I am not going to worship Him. I am suffering because of Him. It's a beautiful poem, I cannot remember in Hindi language. There are such free thinkers who can think deeply. Exactly in the same way. If these five aggregates not combined together, there is nobody to struggle for survival, for fightings and quarreling and sufferings and worrying and crying. We'll be free from all these problems. Again, saṅkhittena pañcūpādānakkhandā dukkha. Dhammapada. No, not Dhammapada. Dhammacakkappavattana sutta. When the Buddha explained dukkha, what is dukkha? Jātipi dukkha, jarāpi dukkha, vyādipi dukkha, maranampi dukkha, yampiccham nalabhati tampi dukkha, appyehi sampayogo dukkho, tvyehi vipayogo dukkho, saṅkhittena pañcūpādānakkhandā dukkha. Very beautifully he explained. How, what kind of sufferings are there? Start from the beginning. Jātipi dukkha, birth creates suffering. There is nothing to argue. When the mother gives birth, mother also crying, baby also crying. Nobody to laugh. You can see the sour face of mother and crying face of baby. Birth gives suffering. And that poor lady had to suffer 9 months earlier, also suffering. That poor baby inside, also suffering. Where is happiness? Jātipi dukkha. Then, jarāpi dukkha, jarā. Decaying dukkha. Look at those old men. Go to old folks' home. How they enjoy their life. The most miserable part of the life. Jarāpi dukkha. Vyadipi dukkha, any kind of sickness. No one is free from sickness. Suffering from sickness. Maranam pi dukkha. Maran, death. Death creates suffering. Actually, death does not create suffering. We create suffering in our mind because of fear of death. Otherwise, death cannot create suffering. Death is very easy. Very easy. Easiest. If we can think, if death is natural, death is not the end of our life. Death is the beginning of our life. Setting sun here is the beginning, the rising sun in another country. Setting sun is not the end of that sun. It is a gradual life. When you analyze in this way, the fear of death. Maranam pi dukkha. Yam picchan nalabhati tam pi dukkha. We suffer when we cannot gain what we want. This is another kind of suffering. Appyehi sampayogo dukkho. When we have to live with very unpleasant, very cunning, very cruel, very wicked people create suffering. Appyehi sampayogo. Even in one family, among brothers and sisters and parents and children, if there is no unity and harmony and love and understanding, appyehi sampayogo dukkho. Living in that family together creates enormous suffering. Appyehi vipayogo dukkho. When we have to separate or depart from our beloved, our loved, father, mother, brother, sister, friend, husband and wife, when we have to separate from them, that creates another kind of suffering. Sankhittena panchu padanakhanda dukkha. The combinations of these five elements and attachment toward these five elements create suffering. See the way how Buddha has explained various kinds of suffering. So we suffer because of this. Then, I don't know how I got into this track now. I wanted to explain the nature of the mind. Oh, this Mara. How many kind of Maras? Sankhara also Mara. Five Sankhara. Our body, our mental faculty, energy. Body creates so many problems and pains and aches and troubles and sicknesses. It's a Mara. Our body is our Mara actually, not a friend. Then the mind is our enemy. Mind creates so much problems. Also Mara. Devaputto kilesocha abhisankhara maro khanda maro machu maro rastu. Machu is death. Death is regarded as maro. Because death creates fear. Death creates unhappiness. Misery. Therefore, we regard this as Mara. Now, this is the how five kinds of Mara the Buddha has explained. So, Durangama runs very far. actually, this is the language. Mind never runs. Remember that. Mind never goes. But the mental energy catch the object, that which exists far away. Mind never goes there. Mental energy catch the object. It is like this. When we see an object, our eyes never go there. Eyes means not this eyeball. We bring the object into the ear eye consciousness. Then the eye consciousness absorbs it. Sound. Ear consciousness never goes out to catch the sound. Sound vibration reach here, then catch. Smell. The smell reach into our nose, and then we experience. Taste. We cannot taste the things which are far away. Must be in our mouth. Then we experience the taste. Feeling. We cannot get the feeling unless we touch or embrace. In the same manner, the mind never goes there, but mental energy can catch the object. That is the idea, durangamam, runs very far. That means can catch the object which are very far away, even in other planets or the other world system. This is the nature of the mind. Now when we radiate, say our kindness, the mind does not go there. The vibration, mental vibration that we created, reach there, not the mind. Now we have a chikku tree here. Always there are fruits. Bats come from batuki every night and enjoy the fruits. The smell of the fruit is the wind, vibration. They have very strong instinct. This is the way how the mind catch the object. Exactly like the fruit and the bat. The nature of the mind, I told you, is very subtle. When we developed our mind, our mental attitude completely changed. When we pollute our mind, again, humane feeling, humane qualities, deprived, dropped. When we pollute the mind, when we cultivate our mind, then we maintain humane qualities, virtues, live as real human beings. The mind is responsible for that. Take a charan, live alone. I told you, ekat kaya nanat sanya. Body, kaya, look like same, equal. Features, complexion and the formation the same. Nanatta Sanya. Nanatta means different. Sanya, mind. Mind different. Now when I look at you, I can see all are equal. That means the features, formation of the body and the face, not much different. But if I can analyze the nature of your mind, entirely different. Your intelligence, your understanding, your grasping capacity, and what you call your character, your temperament, entirely different. This is the nature of it. So live together, work together, it's a very difficult thing. We must have so much tolerance, patience, understanding. Otherwise, we cannot work together. We cannot live together. Differences. So, understanding of the Dhamma support us to know the nature of the mind. Then we know how to adjust ourselves. Some people are, by nature or by birth, from their birth, they have certain characters. It is very difficult for them to change. Very, very difficult. Now, if we try to change, they get angry. They become enemies. Or they keep away from us. That understanding is important. Therefore, we must know he or she is like this. Now, he is very honest. If others are going to meet an honest man, it's a very big problem. Because he never agrees. Cunningness, or with crookedness, or smuggling, or cheating, or bluffing, he never agrees. Then those who work with him cannot. Therefore, others must know he's an honest man. If you are going to work with him, we must know how to associate. And another person is number one crook. Others are innocent. If they are going to do some work or business with this man, not knowing his mentality, they get into trouble. Then they must know. He is a crook, we know. But we know how to work with him. Act wisely. Handle carefully. Then you know how to escape. Another one is very hot-tempered. Get angry for nothing and shout and jump for minor things. Then don't irritate. Because you cannot change that person's mind. You must know how to associate with that person. How to work. When that person shouts, you keep quiet. Think in your mind that he is a fool, but don't tell him. It's a foolish shouting, that's it. Keep quiet. Then there won't be any classes, arguments. The technique, you must know this technique, how to associate. If you cannot associate with them, the Buddha has given another. Because some people cannot tolerate. They do not know how to adjust themselves. Then the Buddha says, Oche labetha nitokam sahayam epo chare sabga visana sabga. If you cannot find out suitable person for you to associate, better to go away from the society, live below. There is no doubt. No harm at all. Now you can understand how to deal, how to handle, how to work with others because of the different mentality. The most difficult thing is understanding them. When we try to tell them, explain certain things, they understand something else. It's not what we are trying to tell people, because they cannot catch it. They cannot understand. Low mentality. I think you can remember, I have explained that we have six kinds of mentality or characters. Can you remember? Cannot, huh? Never mind, repeat. Raga charitta, dosa charitta, moha charitta, buddhi charitta, saddha charitta, vitakka charitta. Six characters we have. We have few of them, not only one or two. Some people are raga charitta. Raga means lustful, romantic. They like only that. They are not interested in income or earning. They like romantic life. That is the purpose of their life. They are happy. That by nature they are, we cannot believe. Raga charitta. The next one is dosa charitta. Dosa here means anger. Hot temper. Dosa charitta means hot temper. There are many. Some people come and shout at us also, our devotees, our members. Minor mistake, they come and shout. But that is their nature. So we should not get angry. Always treat them as fools. Without telling them. Those are charitas. Moha charitas. Low mentality. Very, very low. Very difficult to understand things. Although we explain, cannot understand. The formations of their mental faculties, we cannot force. Buddhi charitta. Intellectual or intelligent. From childhood, we can understand. Very intelligent. It depends on the formations of the brain, cells, the neurons and all sorts of things. Psychologists can explain why they are intelligent, intellectual, formation. But karma is behind for that formation. And I have seen many articles written by teachers. They say, in their classes, it is not necessary to teach to some of their students. Just to remind. They catch the rest. No need to explain. That means their previous experience are still working in their mind. So the teacher's duty is to remind. That is called intelligence. Intelligent means those who have developed their mind during their previous birth. The same mental character or attitude or ingredients start to work in the next life. Because when departed consciousness landed, those ingredients are there. By nature they become material. Vitakka charya, confused mind. Yes, there are many. Cannot decide either to do this or that, or to say yes or no. Always wavering, confused, not clear decision or anything. There are many, cannot decide. So they have to depend on others. They cannot decide. That is why they always come and ask to accept certainty. That is wrong. We should not get the idea from another person to accept. We can get the information from another person and decide. Some people come and ask, Reverend, what do you think about Sai Baba? Now they want to get the idea from me. I say, I never think about it. That's not. Now he cannot get any information from me. It is not necessary for me to think of it. So don't try to get the idea from another person for you to accept at once. You can get some information, then decide, observe. Then the last one, saddhācarita, devout or devotional. Some people are very devout. Devout means faith. They have faith in anything. Whatever people come and tell, especially in the name of religion, they believe and develop their faith. They are like that. And others can bluff them very easily. They become the victims to many people, especially collecting donations for telling all sorts of cock and bull stories about miracles and God and religion. Money, money, money. Ready to give devotion, devotion, faith. It is not very healthy attitude. That devotion is sometimes very dangerous. That devotion is related to emotion. Not intent. So, devotion and emotion go in hand in hand. I am sorry to say, many of our ladies are very devout. They have more devotion. Because they are emotional. And very easy to bluff them. Not according to my experience. Giving donation, you know, these four things, always you had to practice with wisdom. Otherwise you get it. If you always practice kindness, people say you are kind-hearted fool. Yes. Kindness is good, but others can take the advantage to make you fool. Kindness must be practiced with wisdom, understand. Investigate, find out whether it is true or not to extend your kindness, your sympathy. They can come and bluff you. Patience. Everybody says, religion says, must have patience and keep quiet. I think Buddha is the only teacher who has said, only foolish people keep quiet without talking, practicing patience. Because they have nothing to talk. silence is gold. That is not the truth, ultimate truth. This is a temporary, conventional truth. Silence is not gold. Sometimes it can become fire. Silence. This patience and silence must go with wisdom, with understanding. When it is necessary, important for you to be silent, to avoid problems, violence, bloodshed, enmity, problems, silence is good. Otherwise, we had to raise our voice. When the stretching is very important, simply by stretching like this, you don't get feeling. Do like this. Must stretch, then you get the feeling. Raise the voice when it is necessary. Then they get it. Otherwise, no effect. Eka chara. I'm explaining that, isn't it? Live alone. Mind, live or exist alone. Cannot combine with another person. Occasionally, we compromise, we agree, we compromise because of this difference. That is very important. But these two things go individual. If two minds clash together, like electricity, negative and positive. What will happen? Fire. Negative and positive must go separate, cannot join together. Especially male and female. Negative, positive. They must remain as negative and positive. Don't try to make both positive or both negative. No meaning. By nature, masculine and feminine qualities, then the usefulness, happiness, they experience because of this negative positive. If both are equal, no use. So as I mentioned, understanding of the nature and the mind and the mentality, character, is very important, then we can work with others. Asarira. No sarira. No body. Or formation. Because no element. In the mind, there is no element or matter. If there are no elements, invisible. The formations of devas, spirits, brahmas, invisible to our naked eyes because of lesser degree of elements. More energies, mental energies. So we cannot see. The mind. Now, Hinduism, Christianity, Islam, Judaism, Jainism, all these religions very strongly believe that there is a soul. Now, to them, mind is not important. Soul is important. Scientific discoveries of mind at the beginning, they thought mind is the byproduct of the element. When the element combined together, later the development of mind takes place because of this element. But this belief was rejected by Albert Einstein. He had no religion. He said, mind must come first. Elements combine later, join later. Exactly what the Buddha said. He is not talking about religion. He says that is the need. Mind cannot come later. Vijnanam matukuchismim okkamati, what the Buddha says. Vijnana, this departed consciousness, first enter into the mother's womb. That is the first thing. Then all the other cosmic energies and elements, everything combined to build up. So the consciousness is the nucleus of life in the mother's. So the mind is an energy, no one can see it, and the belief that soul is more important than the mind is misinterpretation of the consciousness. Because when you analyze mental energy, there is no place for soul. Feeling, perception, mental habit, consciousness. No soul. But they introduce this as soul. That's it. There is nothing to argue. They say soul. We say consciousness. Same concept. Two words. Only difference is, they say this soul is created by the God. Now, Buddhism is not ready to accept that. Mind or the soul is not created by anybody. The Buddha also cannot create that. Then, where this mind is, this is another controversial. Few thousand years, in every country, in every religion, every philosophy, it is mentioned, mind is in our heart. That is why we have created some word like kind-hearted, kindness, cruelty, they thought in our heart. Later, when the medical science started to develop, they found out mind is not in the heart. It is in our brain. So according to their experiment, they have seen so many indications how the brain work. So they believed this for nearly 100 years, that the mind is in our brain. Today, the modern psychologist says, mind is not in our brain. Mind is not located in any part of our body or organ. Mind is an energy just like electricity. Electricity is not located anywhere. When the friction takes place, fire or electricity appears. But behind this there are so many other forces. No one can explain what sort of forces are there. In the same way, when the heart and the brain work together, combine, of the frictions of heart, the energies of the brain, energies of the heart, like electric current produced by a dynamo. But there must be engine. Engine and dynamo, they are friction, produce electricity. So the brain and the heart, they are friction, produce the mental energy. So that energy is all over the body, not located in any part of the body. When little bit of cut or injury, we experience pain. Pain is here, but the mind is experiencing this pain. If mind is not there, there is nobody to experience the pain. Body cannot experience pain. That means the mental energy is all over the world. And the ancient belief that mind is in our heart is completely rejected after heart transplantation operation.